What are you saying? Who's the mom?
The mother-in-law.
Who's the mom? This to the mother or to the son?
The mother is the mother.
Yes. Who's the daughter or the son?
Oh, to the son.
To the son. Yes. So the daughter is the daughter-in-law.
Yes.
Sharp. So talking about couple.
Couple goals, yeah.
Couple.
There's this couple, right? They got married somewhere and then... Oh, can I please repeat? So, guys, there's this couple somewhere in the world that's getting married, but...
South African couple.
That's what I asked and then you didn't know nothing.
Continue!
On the agreement that the mother-in-law has to pay for the wedding. Oh, fuck, I'm fucking this whole thing up. So, guys, there's a couple in South Africa that's getting married on the condition that... No. There's a couple in South Africa that's getting married on...
Wait, the mother's paying. If she pays, they have one kid.
Thank okay. you, Malum 13K.
So, you're hiding me.
Oh, I'm hiding you.
Yeah.
So, 3, 2, 1.
Dog, the
3, 2, 1, energy.
Energy.
What's up, Dirty Dishes? Y'all know what it is. Another week, another weekly tough. This time around, weekly tough number 7. So, guys, there is a man out there who married his wife because he lost a bet. It happened this way. He lost a bet between his colleagues and he had to take this woman out on a date and he found love.
He ended up falling in love.
Would you be upset if you find out, like, I don't know how many months or days after your wedding,
what if
okay,
it's years,
you lost a day?
Yeah, she found out after 4 years, man.
After 4 years?
How would you feel?
No, you can't be angry. I mean, now you're in love. Things are okay. No, but it was a bet.
These things happen, guys, and the way these things happen is not as fairy tale as you guys always want it to be.
Yeah,
sometimes we lose bets. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So, people, talking about couple goals, there's one couple out there that had a surrogate mom, you know, keep their baby. Of course, that's what they do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Normal so, things, bro. People go through things.
This couple is a full blonde, blue-eyed couple, and their child came out Asian. So, this couple was so... Hey, they were so mad. They were so devastated that they were just like, bruh, keep the baby. We don't want it anymore.
No, wait. Okay, I have a question. Do you think the surrogate mother was pregnant before she became a surrogate mother?
Me, I don't know.
Yes! You know what I'm saying? Because it's possible that she was a couple of weeks pregnant
before.
That's
surrogate.
Because that's the only way it would make sense.
I mean, no. So instead of abortion, I surrogate. Apply. Same
so, man, get money for that. So, man, just like,
you know what I'm saying?
It's a spa,
they took care of her for 9 months, boy, so that she could give birth to her own baby.
But now they don't want the child anymore. What happens to the child and the mom?
Man, it's her baby, most
likely. You see the responsibility.
They're contributing to orphanagism.
Because now they don't want the baby anymore. But what if the baby is theirs, but it has Asian features?
Because of the surrogate mom.
Yes!
So, guys, there's a couple in South Africa that want to get married, right? But their mother-in-law says they can only have one kid and then they'll pay for the whole entire wedding.
I'm going to explain it, but
she wants one grandchild. But she pays for the wedding.
She only wants one
grandchild.
But sometimes you don't make the agreement with the womb, though.
Exactly.
So this is a question to you guys. Would you allow your mother-in-law to pay for the wedding only if you have only one child?
Also, the mother-in-law, remember, this is not just a deal and anything like that. It's a genuine contract. It's a signed contract. So if they have more than one child, they in
what
big
happens?
Trouble.
But what happens? Would the mother-in-law actually sue your son or the daughter? Come on, guys.
Basically, she only wants one grandchild. These are couple goals.
Guys, would you take that deal? Please comment down below. So, we have great people doing great stuff in South Africa, South Africa, actually, you know what I'm saying? Doing great things in the States, go state seeing, you get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
First of all, we have Trevor Noah, who is now the fourth highest paid comedian in the world.
Fourth boy.
Making money, getting the bag.
What are you doing?
Let's maybe try something.
You are making people go ha ha for free.
Aye, look that we can do this.
Another person who's making waves is Stacey Lee May. You might have seen her in music videos such as Vibe by Tero and other music videos by other family tree people. But they're not paying us to say their name, so
this is not promotion.
Anyway, so she's on a new show on Netflix called Hyperdrive, and it is produced by what's her name?
St-
Theron. Okay, yeah, Charlize Theron. And I was shook that she still knows how to speak Afrikaans.
My friends just said,
that's right.
Yeah,
you know. So, Charlize even made an appearance herself to come and see Stacey Lee May, because she's also from South Africa. And she was out there hitting Afrikaans. I was so proud. So, she was in the competition. She would have came first because she had a really good time in the competition. But her engine flooded because there was a part in the course where you have to drive on water. So, unfortunately, she got knocked out. But doing the most anyway.
So now we want to give you the latest that is happening with the Amazon. The Brazilian army has started fighting the fire. They've thrown out planes that are throwing gallons and gallons of liters of water. That's how you do it. You say
gallons
it,
and gallons of
gallons.
Gallons is like liters in America.
Liters. Oh snap! Yeah. So in the Amazon, the Brazilian army has started fighting the fires. They
do you think I'm gonna cut that out?
Slashing.
Like, I don't even get why you're starting all over. Continue, bro.
I know what my business
is. Continue, bro.
So the Amazon is fighting that, and the UK has pledged 180 million rand that it will help Brazil contribute, help them with the finances when it comes to fighting the Amazon. And other countries, other European countries, have asked to ban Brazilians. The other European nations have asked to ban Brazil's beef. Have asked to ban Brazil's beef because farming is a part of the reason why the Amazon is being burnt right now. Mm-hmm. It's to contribute to agricultural purposes and people's cattle. Yes. And hence, the Brazil's beef is asking to be banned when it comes to importing and exporting.
Trading, said Brazil's beef is asking to be banned.
Ah, you're lying.
You did.
Ah.
Anyway.
Not. No.
No.
Anyway.
No.
We don't agree to this video on
YouTube. All right, guys, from our side, on Friday, we went out to a shoot that happened at Standard Bank. On Sunday, we got invited by the YouTuber CreateZA that happened at Pretoria in Hatfield.
Relish Bistro.
Yes. Mm-hmm. That happened at Pretoria Hatfield Relish Bistro, where we got to meet some...
Say that again.
Bistro. What is it? What is it?
Bistro, bro.
Bistro.
Anyway, here's the footage of some of the shandies that was going down.
I can't say that word.
Great YouTubers
Gango. Bistro!
Great YouTubers like Tato Rampedi. Great YouTubers like Dead Edition.
The Divining Media Team.
Yes.
Shout out to your dirty dishes. These people look amazing, number one. Okay. Number two,
yes.
People have their conversation on lock.
So they just
tune in to their YouTube
channel. You had that.
You know, like, subscribe, yay, yonki into babes. So yes.
Shout out to you. Yeah, you heard what she said. You better do that.
For watching this video, for taking your data out to watch us, you know, YouTubers, you know,
we know how expensive data is
without you guys. So yes,
shout out.
Thank you so much. We love you guys. Remember to iron your clothes before you leave for class. And
remember, the dishes ain't dirty
for nothing.
And are you a thick-based or thin-based person? Tell us.
Wait. Are you hungry or are you eating for preference? Now, you go to Romans when you're hungry, dog. That's why you're not thin.
I don't know when last I've eaten for preference.
I'm not from there. Wait, you go to Romans when you're not hungry. The first thing, you know what I'm saying? Especially when you're broke. We consider it next.
I like the identification, especially when you're broke.
Rich
people can eat.
Do you think eating bread is fun?
No, there's nothing fun about
it. That's what happens. That's what happens when
you eat beans. Just like that.
That's what happens when you eat thick beans.
No.
The jamuro, though.
We are, yes.
Got cheese in your
hand. The quantity, you want more quantity, bro.